Hey friends, welcome back to part 4 of 5x5 with me, London Souza. Today we're going to talk about practicing your calendar. So in the last video, I taught you how to make your calendar more efficient or time audit yourself in order to make your calendar. But in this video, I want to tell you that you need to practice. You need to not only make your calendar, but see if it actually works for you. Because sometimes we make a list of everything that we're gonna do for the day, and then things just don't work out the way that we planned. Sometimes you can create a calendar and you think, oh my God, this is amazing, this is perfect, I can't wait until Monday to get started. And then you do it and you're like, whoa, 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 whoa. Like, this does not work for me. And this happened to me. So as I was making my transition from my office job to where I am now, I created this calendar. It was super colorful. Everything was color coordinated in terms of when I would be doing what. And when it came time to actually execute, the way that I had built my calendar just was not working for my new lifestyle at all. And I spent about 2 weeks beating myself up. You know, we talked about self-talk in the previous videos, that I was a failure, that I couldn't, you know, get the swing of things of being an entrepreneur again, that because, you know, I wasn't doing my workout in the morning and then getting in my my meditation immediately afterwards, that I was somehow this failure because I couldn't follow this calendar. But I'm here to tell you that your calendar is not set in stone. So once you make this schedule, once you set out your block of time of what you need to get done, practice. Test it out. Does it actually really work for your real life? And if it doesn't, make adjustments. Don't be afraid of that. Or else you're gonna find yourself a few steps back where we talked about it, having that negative self-thought. And I had that too. I was like, oh, you know, I can't seem to fit this in. It's been a full day and I can't even think about what I've accomplished because I was obsessing so much about being in this order. So what did I do? I took the time to make those changes because, like I talked about in video 1, I already had shook hands with change. I had already started doing things a little bit different. So when it came time to make these changes in my calendar, it was okay. It wasn't a big deal. I just had to go for it. And you know, the funny thing was, is I've always been the type of person that wakes up and wants to do their workout first thing in the morning. But now that I'm an entrepreneur and self-employed, I found that when I wake up in the morning and then do my workout and have breakfast and do all of these things, there was like 3 hours of unproductive time that I was wasting. And then in the afternoon, when I kind of wanted to just relax, I ended up having to cram in all that work that I missed in the morning. So what did I do? I rearranged my schedule. I made it so that when I wake up in the morning, I kind of plan my day a little bit. I get in some work, I finish some emails, then I do my workout, then I go into my into the things that I need to get done. And that's worked out so much better for me. Even though for the last 12 years of my life that I've been in this fitness, wellness, personal development space, I've always done my workouts first thing in the morning. Now that my lifestyle has changed a little bit, I've had to make those shifts. So in this video, this tip for you is after you make your calendar, test it out, practice. Is it working for you? Do you find that you're being more productive, or do you find that you're being more negative towards yourself and getting more frustrated because you're not meeting the standards that you set for yourself? So that's your homework for this video. I want you guys to not only have your calendar, but practice it. Practice it for a week, for 2 weeks. Is it working out for you? Where can you make some changes? Where can you make some shifts? But bottom line, even when you make your calendar, it's not always gonna be perfect. There are gonna be little tweaks and things like that, and you'll be really good at getting acquainted with change, of course. But your homework is to practice your calendar and make adjustments as needed. We'll see you next time for video number 5, our last one. Thank you guys for joining.